Theresa May is an awful Prime Minister and a shambolic leader. This is historical fact, as we know. But just how awful is she? In this series, I compare her to other awful PMs to see just how awful she really is. Continuing today with Harold Macmillan. Harold Macmillan was a fiercely determined Prime Minister who, after telling the British people that they'd never had it so good, promptly made sure that they never had it ever again by freezing wages to stop rising inflation, thereby pricking a balloon full of shit right in front of his face and signalling his inevitable decline. However, despite his permanent facial expression that suggested he'd rather be at home eating a pie, Harold Macmillan was also a ruthless and calculating little shitweasel, and no event illustrated this more than his decision to sack a third of his cabinet in one evening, which even by today's standards is still a breathtakingly Machiavellian dick move. Theresa May could only dream of such self-confidence. As it is, she's a prisoner within her own cabinet, shackled to a pillowcase of asbestos, otherwise known as the worst foreign secretary in living memory. A man who thinks he can just dismiss the national disgust towards him as a bit of a lark, like he were a sitcom character or a pantomime villain, when in actual fact he's a dangerously inept, odious, arrogant, sexist, racist, blobfish-faced fuck. Harold Macmillan may have his critics for what he did to the economy in the 60s, but at least we know that had he lost control of his faculties and appointed a poisonous sack of sausage meat as foreign secretary, he would almost certainly have flung it under a bus the moment it made him look bad. And that is why he is not as awful as Theresa May. Join me next time, where I'll be comparing another awful Prime Minister to Theresa May.